Namaste everyone, this is Jinal and thank you so much for the introduction, Gaurav. I think the title looks a little different. I've just tried to use all the different languages that we have in India, that's Hindi, English, Tamil, Malayalam, Gujarati, into the title, and just to show that, you know, there's so many languages here. So as I start off, So back in 2007, the canvas of India looks blank. There's no data and there are very little contributions, and it sort of marked the beginning of OSM in India. You can see there are small lines in Chennai, where one of our, he's known as the map man of India, Arun Ganesh, also known as Plain Man, actually started off exploring the domain of like OpenStreetMap. So in 10 years, you can see the number of nodes, the density is increased. There's a lot of data on the map, and we've also reached like a phase where, you know, the thing is creation to use. As we have this data, how are we using it? And in this presentation, I will be trying to highlight few of the many activities that happen around India with different communities, and try to get everyone on the same page, but I hope I've covered everyone. So as I go, to just start off with some basic statistics around it, we have like on an average 14,000 nodes that have been created on a daily basis. There's a spike on the 30th of June in 2015. I did try searching for any of these activities which lead to the spike, but we realized that Zipper, which is one of the address location providers in India, have started mapping buildings in India. So I will come to the slide as to how many buildings they have mapped, but this was the reason of the spike. And you can see the number of active contributors. On an average, there are around 50 active contributors in India, where something which was a little stunning fact to me was that over the weekends, the graph goes down. Over the week, it goes up. So I think I can draw a conclusion to this that we do have people who regularly contribute to OSM and take a break over the weekend. This spike was also very relative to the Zipper mapping buildings in India. And this is basically just showing an overview of how it is like and what it is like with respect to the different years, like starting from 2012 to 2017. So when we came to number of unique keys, we have around 4,000 unique keys, which has doubled since the last year. And out of these, there are 1,600 odd unique keys that do not have a wiki page. So yes, we have some work to do in documentation. So yes, my expression after seeing this is like, oh, there is so much data. Like we have really well-mapped cities. I'm just trying to show a few of them, but there are too many. And there's Bangalore, because this is the place where I am from, and I'm really proud to show that it's really well mapped. Then there's Taj Mahal, which is very popular among everyone, and you also have tea stalls that are mapped, if you go a little deeper, so we can understand how intricate OSM data is and how well can we use this. Then the next question comes into picture is, this is 2007 and this is 2017, who made this happen? The answer is the OSM community. So right now, I wasn't able to get like a screenshot of all the contributors, but at this Zoom level, we have so many contributors, and if you can see, the majority of them are someone who's just starting. So there's a lot of work for us to do to retain these contributors. And as I proceed, I will try to highlight few of these activities and events that have happened across few years, where we've tried to get the community together and build maps together. So we're making the world's best map step by step. I'd start with Kerala, which is God's own, it's a beautiful state. There are a few of the being very active contributors. Amongst them, few of them are Naveen, Jason, Manoj, Kishore. They've been actively trying to bring the OSM community together by different activities around. They've gotten the national, they've started mapping the national highways. They're trying to bring Wikidata and OSM together. They're conducting mapathons and everything around Kerala. So in the next slides, I'll be showing up a few of the things that they've been doing. So the transport department of Kerala have started using OpenStreetMap. They're using this to track 1,500 odd trucks to just track where they're going and how they're navigating. And here you can see in the picture, the department is using OSM and they're mapping, and this is a crowdsourced project, so the team and the community is involved in doing so. Then this is the Velur Panchayat mapping party, which was again by the few of the active members of the community, where they got together, they taught mapping to the village community, as well as they mapped the village with all the intricate details. Then the next one was again the unsurveyed land of Kurachundu, where it was a very similar mapping party where they got the community together, they taught mapping and they went ahead. Then Cycle, I think he's presenting in the State of the Map, like Asia, and he's been doing a lot of work around hiking, mapping hiking trails, mapping villages, and a lot of it. So this is something very important because we tend to miss out. We do have coverage in cities, but we tend to miss out villages, and this is a really important contribution. Then Yogesh, as I mentioned that we have so many languages, and it's hard for us to, you know, English has become, predominantly, but we have maps in Kannada, and one major contributor is Yogesh, who's been translating and adding Wikidata to OSM, and you can see we have the whole world map in Kannada, which is one of the Indian languages. Then, as I spoke about Zipper, they are contributed to 3+ million building in India, and if they're continuing to do, and you can know more about them in their website. Then, as the slogan says here, from creation to use, we do have this data, and you know, it's at disasters when we realize that how we can use this data really well. So, Chennai flood map was something that came out of a hackathon where my colleagues Arun, also known as Plain Mat, and Aruna got together and you know, built this map where you can basically select a street and say it's flooded or not. And this map is not just limited here, but it's been used in different places. Recently, it's a similar thing inspired by this was to map Hurricane Harvey, the flood map, where you can choose the street and say it's flooded if you need requirements. Then another map, which is a disaster reporting system, which it is an Android app by Psychot. This is basically you can click and choose the lane and say if you need help, you need clothes, you need you need someone to pick you up, you're stuck, and all of it. So you can see this data has been used widely and how it can be of great help when a disaster starts. Then it comes to like resources that we have across like the nation. So Gopi Labs is one of the important things where they're actually mapping trees and trying to find out the species and different things, how many resources that are available. A similar initiative was done by a team where we have like a mapillary drive, you can search for it. And this is, her name is Timaka, and the name Salu Marada indicates that she's planted 100 odd trees. And we went to a Mapley drive and we've actually added all these trees into OpenStreetMap. So if you see that lane is filled with trees with all the details. And we started off with mapping interest in school. So we went to schools across, in Bangalore to teach kids not maybe OSM, but the basics of maps and get them interested in it from the beginning. And that itself, tells, and it was really beautiful to see them, interested and exploring the globe and playing with the maps and, you know, giving the world in their hands would be the right thing to say about this. So getting the community together. So we had a hackathon where we got the developers, we improved the OpenStreetMap.in site, we explored a lot of things, and this was the first time ever something happened in Bangalore. It was a great gathering and it was great to see different people coming in, pouring in ideas over the weekend. And we hope that we continue to do this. Then there was another workshop by the same activist in Thrissur, where they got together and trained all of these university students. Something which again Saikat did it in Mumbai, which is very recent, about like a mapathon teaching 50 odd participants how to map OpenStreetMap and like humanitarian response. So yes, these are things, and how are the challenges? India being a multilingual nation, and I think Kate pointed out that everything is pretty much dominated in English, so it's hard to reach out to the major population. So how are we thinking about doing this or coming across that it reaches more people? We do have smartphone users. India are having 1.4 billion population. We have around 300 million users, but still, it's not a good ratio. Internet. Internet is not available everywhere, so we cannot use these apps irrespective of us having maps or phones. So how are we thinking about these? So growing the existing community, like, we do have these challenges, and what are the things that we would want to grow these communities? Like, we have OSM diaries where we, you know, write and share all of, I encourage everyone to use this so that, you know, you can share what you're doing with the entire OSM community. We have the talk list where you can ask any question and there would be some response from anyone. Right now we have 248 subscribers, which is a really less number, but I'm hoping that will increase. We have IRC where you can join and ask anyone any question around the world. We have the Facebook group, and with my small research that I did, I know that, in Asia, Facebook groups are predominantly more active over any other channel. So I'm hoping to connect with you all on the Facebook group. And this weekly OSM, so this is something which I contribute to. It is currently available in 8 languages, but I'm hoping that we have more people. I think one is in Japan, one is available in Japanese, and I'm hoping that if everyone's interested, we can have a conversation and start this in your own language. This is basically a weekly newsletter about the OpenStreetMap news across the world. And have more events. I think a lot of people have mentioned about universities being an important entity. Have more events across and continue doing that. Improve the existing data. This map basically shows the unnamed streets. So we do have data, but we do not have data which has some meaning. And some open questions is like, how do we retain users? We do have these events and we have a lot of members contributing to it, but they stay active only for a couple of days. So how do we go ahead with this? And yeah, are you facing similar challenges and have ideas? Let's meet. Let's make this conference a way where we can integrate and contribute and work on these ideas together. Open data is future. Open data will win. Thank you.